Hi, welcome to the 48th chapter in Selenium using C Sharp. In this video, we are going to discuss about how to take the screenshot of specific element using extension method. The agenda of this video is take the screenshot of specific element using extension method. First, let's see what is capturing screenshot. Selenium WebDriver provides the capability to capture the screenshot during the test execution. It always a good to capture the screenshot of the test results if you are running the test overnight. The capability to take the screenshot with the Selenium is extracted from iTake screenshot interface that allowing us to take a screenshot of the current page displaying in the web instance. Now in this video, we are going to discuss how to take the screenshot of specific element using extension method. Now let's see what is extension method. Extension methods are enable you to add a methods to an existing types without creating a new derived type, recompiling or otherwise modifying the original type. An extension method is a specific kind of static method. Now let's see how to take the screenshot of specific element using extension method. See, we have to create a one class, that is here I have created a class of utils. In that I have created one static method, that is a take screenshot to. In this is an extension method. For that we need to pass the this web driver and a web element, and I have created one string variable that capturing the time and the date and the extension with the .jpg, and I am creating a one byte array. There I am typecasting the iTake screenshot, and I am storing that with a get screenshot method and as byte array property. And here I am creating an object of bitmap class, and here I am saving that in the memory, so that I need to pass the variable of byte array. And I am also creating an object of rectangle. Here I will capture the x and y coordinates location and height and width of the particular element. After that I will use a clone method to the cropped image, and I will store that in a pixel format. After that I will save using a screenshot.save method in the format. Here I will give the file name and the image format. And finally I will call it in the main method by passing a web element inside the method. Now let's see how to operate, how to work on that in the Visual Studio. See, here I will copy the first four lines of previous code. Here I will rename the method as screenshot of element using extension method. Once I done with this, I have created the object of WebDriver. Here also I will pass the AnkPro website URL. Here I need to capture the content of this much, means I need to take the screenshot of this class, that is having a Jumbotron, class name of Jumbotron. For that I will create one class in the name, that is in static class in the name of utils. After that I am going to create one method inside the class, that is also in static method. The method is take screenshot. Once I done with this, here I need to pass the web driver and an web element. This is here we are going to create an extension method, so that I need to pass this keyword. Here I am passing iWebDriver driver and iWebElement. After this, here I am going to create one string. Variable name is file name. Here I am taking a date now, date time dot now property. Here I will use a toString method. Inside the toString method I will pass the year, month and date, and I need a time for that: hour, minute and second. Once I done with this, I will give the format of the image along with that, that is JPG. Once I done with this, here I will create an one byte array . The variable name is byte array. Here I will typecast the iText screenshot interface. Here I will use a get screenshot method. Dot year I will use a as byte array property. Once I done with this, I will rename this as 1. I will create an object of bitmap. Here I will take a screen shot as a variable name, new bitmap. Here I have to save that one in the memory, so I will use new system dot io dot memory stream. In the memory stream I will pass a byte array. After that I have to create the object of rectangle, so I will pass the variable name as cropped image is equal to new rectangle. Inside that I will pass element dot location dot x coordinate and element dot location dot y coordinate and element dot size dot width and element dot size dot length, width or size dot height. Once I done with this, I need to use the screenshot variable is equal to screenshot dot clone, so that it will cut the screenshot to the our x1 y locations. Here I need to pass cropped image variable in the pixel format screenshot dot . After that again I need to use screenshot dot, I need to save the image. Here I will use string dot format. I will take file name comma image format. Dot I will take a JPEG. once I done this much, I need to call this method in the main method, that is driver dot take screenshot one. Here I need to pass driver dot find element by dot class name, that is having a class name, that is I need to copy the class name control V. After this I need to quit the browser to close the browser window. Now let's run the test case. See, it has launched the browser. It will pass us the URL and it will close the window. Now I will right click on this one. I will go for open folder in a file explorer. I will go for bin. In bin I will go for debug. See, if I click on this, this is the image what we got, and we got a here time and the dot jpg extension. Like this we will capture the screenshot of a specific element using an extension method. The possible interview questions on this topic is how to capture the screenshot of specific element using an extension method. Subscribe to our channel on YouTube, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter and join our group on LinkedIn. And finally, don't forget to give your feedback in comment section. Thank you.